Hello there, my name is Dominic and a few years ago I made a video about how to test backlight. And in this video, I had three methods. One was using a bench power supply. Number two was using that automatic backlight tester available on AliExpress. And number three was using a multimeter. Now, when you are on site, like I was recently preparing a TV for a customer, when you're on site, you can't carry a bench power supply, a variable bench power supply. And I still don't have that automatic backlight tester from AliExpress that I said I was going to buy. By the way, I will link that video in the video description below as well as in the pinned comment. So what I normally use is a multimeter. Now, what happens when your multimeter doesn't work? Well, that's why I'm making this short live video to show you a solution that I've come up with. The backlight in question that I'm talking about are this backlight. These are from a Vitron smart television. And you can't use a multimeter, like I will show you in a few minutes. I couldn't use a multimeter to test this backlight. But interestingly, I have this other two backlight. This one is also from a Vitron smart television. And this one, I can easily use my multimeter to test this backlight, as can I use this very old backlight from LG. This is from, I believe, a 2012 model. So let me set up my camera on my bench behind me so that I can show you the method that I've come up with. Since our LEDs are diodes, we use the diode mode on our multimeter, and I will demonstrate how I use it to test these two backlights. You just place the red positive one on the positive and the black one on the negative. And it's a little bit, I hope you can see that. You can see it's lit, it lights up very dimly. And this is how you can test these lights. So it's very easy to use your multimeter when you are at a customer's place. But that is not the case with these things that I replaced at the customer's place, because I simply can't use this multimeter to test these backlights. They simply do not work at all. Look at the multimeter. It's showing nothing. Even if I reverse the polarity, it's just showing nothing. Now look at the multimeter when I test these other lights. You can see it's changing. And if I interchange the polarity, nothing. Well, nothing is happening when I'm testing this. Now, this is the solution that I've come up with. This is a normal charger. It's a phone charger from an XTG feature phone. Now, the output voltage is 5 volts at 500 milliamperes. And to this charger, I have attached these two leads. These are just screwdrivers. The red one is the positive and the black one is the negative. Now using this, it's not something very heavy that you can carry to your customer's place. You just plug it into the electricity and you just use the positive on the positive and the negative lead, which is the black one on the negative. And you can see the light actually works. So using this method, you can actually test every single LED to see if it's working. Let me start with the old LEDs from LG. Let's test this light. You can see it's working from the other Vitron TV. It's also brighter, it's working. Now, when I repaired this TV had a swollen capacitor, like I've shown you in a previous short video and also longer video. Now, when I replaced the swollen capacitor, I thought that that would fix the TV, but it didn't get fixed. So I had to dismantle the TV to remove these two backlights. Now, testing it with the multimeter didn't work, so there was no way for me to know whether the backlight was actually bad. But if I had this small gadget that I have made, that would have made it easier. So I just did some guesswork, replaced this, and the TV worked. Now I'm going to test every single LED so that we can see how well my gadget works. I will start from this end and test each and each one, each LED from left to right. That is the positive and negative. That one is working. That one is working. Working. That one is also working. Seems like this LED is not working, because when I use exactly the same points on this other strip, you can see this LED is working. What about here? That one is working, as well as this one. And lastly, the last two. Seems this one is not working, but this one is working. So we have two LEDs, this one and this one are not working. So if I only had this gadget with me, and now I'm going to start carrying this everywhere, every time I go to repair backlights. So I was indeed right, the backlight was spoiled. So that's it. My name is Dominic. Thank you for watching this short live stream. Please like this video, share it with your friends. Subscribe if you haven't subscribed, and let's meet in the next video. And by the way, you can also use any phone charger that you have. Phone charger with 5 volts is the best. So thank you again for watching, and goodbye.